Hello children, welcome you all in today's class. In today's class, we will be seeing the homework answers of questions that was given in the previous class, and also we will look into exercise 6.2. Okay? So look here, the 7th question, we have to find all the integers that is lying between 0 and minus 7. Okay? So start writing. So in the number line, minus 7 will be here, after that you will have minus 6, then minus 5. So like this in the number line you will have, and here you will have 0, and after that you will have the positive numbers. Yes or no? So minus 7, minus 6, minus 3, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, and then 0. So all these numbers you have to write here. Okay. So write minus 6. Don't start from minus 7. Start from minus 6. Because between 0 and minus 7. So minus 5, then minus 4, minus 3, minus 2. And minus 1. After minus 1, you will have 0. Don't write 0 because 0 is already given. Next, minus 4 and plus 4. So here you will start with minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. That's all. Because 4 is already given, so you may not write 4. Okay. Next, 8th question. Write 4 integers less than minus 10. Less than minus 10 means those numbers should be on the left side of minus 10 on the number line. Okay. So, in a number line, you will have positive numbers on the right hand side and negative numbers on the left hand side. So, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. And here you will have minus 10. So, on the left side of minus 10, what will you have? Minus 11, minus 20. Then you will have minus 100. Okay. Then you will have minus 54. So, like this, you will have many integers that are on the left side of minus 10, and all those integers are less than minus 10. So clear. Now children, now let us see the 9th question. For the following statements, with write true or false. The statement is false, correct the statement. Okay. So what is the first statement given? Minus 8 is to the right of minus 10 on the number line. Is it true or not? On the number line, which is bigger, minus 8 is bigger or minus 10 is bigger? Minus 8 is bigger, right? So minus 8 will be on the right side of minus 10. That is true. Okay. Next, minus 100 is to the right of minus 50 on number line. No, because minus 50 is bigger than minus 100. So on the number line, minus 100 will be this side and minus 50 will be this side. So this is false. And if you correct the statement and if you write, you will write then minus 100 is to the left of minus 50 on the number line. Okay. Next, smallest negative integer is minus 1. Is it true? No. Biggest negative integer is minus 1. Because after minus 1 you have 0. 0 is neither negative nor positive. Okay. And on a number line, any number that is on the right end is the bigger number, right? So here minus 1 is the negative integer that is on the right, and all other numbers to the right side of minus 1 is positive other than 0. Okay, so here minus 1 is the biggest negative integer. So this is actually false, and if you correct the statement, you will write biggest negative integer is minus 1. Okay, next, minus 26 is greater than minus 25. Is true? No, here also it is false. Only the first statement is true, other statements are false, because maybe the number may be bigger, but when minus sign comes, this number becomes smaller than minus 25. Clear children? Next we will see the 10th question. Draw a number line and answer the following. Okay, so here B subdivision, which number will we reach if we move 5 numbers to the left of 1? Okay, so on a number line, okay, so you have 1 here, and you have to move towards the left side of 1 5 times. Okay. So this will be 0, minus 1, then minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Like this. So 5 jumps. 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So you will reach at minus 4. Okay. So which number will we reach? We will reach at minus 4. Next, D subdivision. If we are at minus 6 on number line, in which direction should we move to reach minus 1? Which direction we have to move? We have to move towards the right direction, because minus 1 is greater than minus 6, right? Minus 6 will be here and minus 1 will be here on a number line.
minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. Okay, so you will write right side. So you have to move to the right side, right direction. Okay, when you have to reach minus 1. Okay, that's all we have discussed, all the homework answers.
Now let us see some problem from exercise 6.2. So here we have the first question, 3 more than 5. Okay, so in this throughout exercise, we are going to find the sum of integers and the difference of integers. Okay, in some problems we will use number line and find, and in some other problem we will directly find the sum or difference of integers. Okay, so in the first question, the question is, using the number line, write the integer which is 3 more than 5. Okay, so now we have to use number line here. So let me draw a number line. Use your scale and draw. Here it is plus 5, right? So I need not go to the negative side. So simply I will write minus 1 and I will leave it as it is. Then I will start with 0, then 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then it goes on like that. 9, 10, okay. So now we have to start from 5, because 3 more than 5. So start from 5 and 3 more than 5. So 1, 2, 3. So 3 steps I have moved. Since it is given more, then I have to move towards the right side. If it is given less, then we have to move towards the left side. Okay, so keep it in mind. More than, that is right side, and less than, that is left side. Okay, L and L. Okay, just remember it. So here the answer is 8. When we move 3 steps more than minus 5, sorry, more than plus 5, we reach at plus 8. Next, coming to the next subdivision, here we are concentrating on the negative part. So start from 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and it goes on. Okay, so start with minus 2, 3 less than minus 2. So from minus 2, we have to move 3 steps to the left side. So 1, 2, 3. So we reach at minus 5. So 3 less than minus 2 is minus 5. So clear, children? So in this way, you will use number line and find the answer of the given statement. Now coming to the second question. Here, the question is, use number line and add the following integers. So 9 plus minus 6 is given. Okay. Now, let us draw the number line. Okay. So start from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and it goes on. Okay. First, we are starting with 9. So this is plus 9 or minus 9? Plus 9, right? So from 0, you have to travel to plus 9. Then you have to go minus 6. Okay. So from 9, you have to come 6 steps towards the left side. Minus means left side. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so you reach at plus 3. Okay, so at last you will write the answer as 9 plus minus 6 equal to plus 3. So in this curve you can write plus 9, and here you can write minus 6. Okay, is it clear? So coming to the next one, here everything is given in negative integers. So draw your number line and you can start from 1, then you will go with 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and so on. Okay, so then you have to start with minus 1. Okay, so where is minus 1? Minus 1 is here, right? Okay, so from 0 you will move to minus 1 first. Okay, so this is minus 1. Then what will you do? Then from minus 1, you have to move to minus 2 steps towards the left side. Minus 2, right? Don't consider this symbol. Consider this one. So 2 steps towards the left side. That is 1, 2. So 2 steps towards the left side. That is minus 2. Then from there, you will move 3 steps towards the left side again. 1, 2, 3. Okay? So minus 3. So at last, you reach at minus 6. So finally, you will write minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus 3 is equal to minus 6. Okay? So in this way, you will use your number line and find the sum of given integers. Okay? So that's all for today's class. Go through the video once or twice and try to understand everything that is taught.